I put the trash out. Anna, you could at least wash the dishes.
I need to do my homework.
I'm going to put your father to bed.
Compensate you greatly. your face. Take that head off.
Sir, this is my face. I can't take my face off. Look, think about my outfit. House, clothes, and food. For Laura.
House, clothes, food, beautiful home? Absolutely not. It is impossible. Get out!
Just think about my outfit. I'll be back shortly.
Dad, I could go. The family would be better off if I go.
What are you, insane? You're talking about running off with a weirdo in a polo bear costume. Do you even know this guy?
No, but there's something about him I trust. He looks mean and ferocious, but... Look, we need his help. Then you can rest your back, Thomas can go back to school, and Nolly could go see a doctor. I would be one less mouth to feed.
I can't give you up, Roar.
Who are you yelling at?
The white bear.
What white bear?
The one that was staring at me.
What? He came to the house? Are you hurt?
No, he wasn't mean at all, and he could talk. His name is Jason.
What?
Not only could he talk, he said that Laura would go live with them. We could have a beautiful house, warm clothes, and lots of grub.
Hey, you'll never believe what I found in the neighbor's trash.
What's going on?
Nothing!
Is everything okay?
Fine! Laura, you must stay with us. I don't care about that other stuff.
What's up? That bear walked in here and asked to take Laura in exchange for a great big house. Lots of beautiful clothes and all the food we could ever eat. We would never have to want again. I think she should do it. Family.
You are so cruel. Can't we give him Anna instead?
Look, I want to stay here, but if I go, Mama wouldn't have to do so much hard work. Father could rest, and not only your leg could get well again. If I could have a new dress.
I want you here.
If I don't go, I'm being very selfish.
No.
Maybe you wouldn't have to stay long. He might let you come back and visit us. He seems kind and heartless. I will go with him.
Laura, no.
I've come for your answer. Have my word. She will not be harmed.
No.
Should I kick him? Come on!
You can have more. Just ask Jason.
Why is he so good to me?
He has a kind heart.
Have you always been his housekeeper?
I've always been his friend. I hope you two will become friends as well.
In the afternoons, we sit in the garden and talk.
What do you talk about?
Almost everything, but one thing puzzles me.
What's that?
When he comes in after supper, why does he put out all the candles and sit in the dark?
That is one question you must never ask.
Hello, Laura.
Hi.
I have something for you.
You've given me so much already.
Here, you show her, Mayla.
Oh, how beautiful. Thank you, Jason.
There's more.
All this for me?
I just want you to be happy.
You know I am.
You are glad you came, right?
Yes, but...
What is it, Laura?
I miss my family so much. I wish I could see them again. To see if they're happy.
They're very well. I'm sure that everything I promised is done. Come, let's take a walk in the garden.
She's homesick. I feel sorry for her.
Feel sorry for yourself if Queen Helga ever hears you say that. Now listen!
I'm listening, but I think I hear someone coming.
don't have to work all day.
I like to keep busy.
I don't. Ever since Laura went to that white bear, we've had a wonderful life.
I hope she's all right.
Of course she is.
Look, okay, I can actually run now.
A few weeks rest and your physical therapy and your brand new way owe to all of the Laura.
Do you think she's happy with him?
I hope so. I wish she would at least call.
Maybe I'll buy a new dress tomorrow.
Your closet is almost full.
Don't you ever wonder about Laura?
Sometimes.
I'm home.
Laura!
You're
look.
Back!
Look, no pain. I can actually run now.
Wow, I missed you all so much. You look so well and happy.
Mom and Dad will be so happy to see you. Mom has barely smiled since you left.
Where are they? I want to see them.
Out back in the garden. Come and look at it.
Thank you. make sure that he is asleep, and that way he won't know what you have done. It is the only way to know if he is a troll. It is the only way to be completely safe.
Oh no, he made me promise not ever to do that.
He made you... Oh no! Then he must be a troll, or you can't ever go back there. It is too dangerous.
I promised him I would go back. Besides, there's no way that the white bear can be a troll. He's too good and kind-hearted to me.
It's a disguise. Have you ever seen his face?
No.
Laura, just go and look. Take this flashlight and just have a quick look. Then you'll know for sure. It can't hurt to try.
But he asked me not to.
Please, Laura, please.
All right. I'll do it if it will make you feel better. I promise to return to him soon, and it is getting dark.
What about dinner?
I'm sorry, Mother, but I have to go.
Girl. pretended to come back.
No, she promised. I don't know what to do. I'm tired. I think I'll lie down for a bit. Thank you, Bela. Will you wake me with your terms?
Of course, dear. You've been so patient for so long. I wish I could have more of a help to you these past years, but Queen Helga's magic is far stronger than mine. Rest now.
Yay! Hello, I'm back.
Jason will be glad to see you in the morning. He's turned in for the evening, worn out from waiting and worry. He thought you were not coming back.
I promised him I would, and I'll stay as long as he wants me to. I did miss you and him while I was away.
How is your family?
They're fine. Jason was kind to them as well. I'm so tired from my travels. I think I'll return to my room for the Good night, Bela.
Good night. Watching over him for these past years, keeping him safe.
And now I have ruined it all because I didn't trust him. Bela, I will find a way to get there and get him back. I will.
Look beyond the wide meadows of tall grass to a deserted, lonely place. I wish you luck on your journey.
Thank you.
I've heard your whispers on the wind. I hear you have troubles.
I've done a terrible thing. I've ruined a good friendship and lost the man that I love.
All is not lost. Come and sit with me a while. I am Mita, mother of the wind. This is my dwelling place. I see many lost souls pass through, looking for a place to hide from the world and from their troubles. I usually don't make my presence known. I just listen as they shout their frustrations to the sky. I've seen many crazy people pass through, blaming their problems on everyone else.
Why are you telling me this?
Because, dear, you are different.
What do you mean?
I can only help those who want to help themselves. You are here to make right the wrong that you have done. You've assumed all responsibility for your actions and have made the choice to fix them, no matter what it costs. Am I right?
Yes.
Then I will do what I can to help you. What is your will?
I must travel to the land of the trolls to find the Troll Queen. I'm told she lives east of the sun and west of the moon.
I have heard of it.
Is it far?
Too far for any mortal.
But I must get there, somehow.
My daughters have spoken of the Troll Kingdom.
Could you ask them to take me there?
I'm not sure if they're strong enough, but I will ask. I will summon the West Wind.
Mother, you have summoned me.
West Wind, this is Laura. She needs to go to the land east of the sun and west of the moon. Can you take her there?
I blow softly on the flowers in the field and on the branches of the trees green with leaves. But I do not go to that dismal land. My strength isn't great enough. I am sorry.
I will summon the south wind.
I bring gentle rains to growing things and guide birds on their flight. To that cold land they never go. My strength is not great enough. I'm sorry.
It doesn't look good. I'll summon the east wind. To the land east of the sun and west of the moon. Can you take her there?
I bring heavy rain over the land, and the birds will hide from me. But I will not flow to that dismal place. My sister the North Wind is the strongest. Ask her.
I shall summon her.
Thank you.
Oh, clumsy one, what are you doing?
The principal is a ruffle, Your Highness.
No ruffle.
No ruffle.
Her own natural beauty must outshine the gown.
You're always making mistakes.
What'd you say?
Jason, can you hear me?
That's Fayla's voice.
But I thought you said she couldn't come here.
I put a wall magic around the castle. She can't come in here, but a voice can. Go away, Fayla! My magic is stronger than yours! You're powerless to enter!
I won't.
Where's Waldo? Guards! Go get Waldo at once. This is great. This is just great. Things were going so well. I will not tolerate distractions.
You stepped really
fast. That took you so long.
The guard just gave us the message.
I will send him to limbo after the wedding.
We accomplished our mission.
I know that, but we must stay on guard just in case something happens. Send your men to their post right away. What's the matter with that one?
I brought him to be punished.
What has he done?
He tried to warn the girls not to look at the bear.
You dared?
Yes.
You failed to do your duty as a troll. Guards! Take him to the dungeon, wrap him up in spiderweb. I will send him to limbo later.
Oh, please, let me explain.
Oh, shut up.
No. Let this be a lesson to any troll who dares to defy me.
Your Highness, there is a girl in the hallway, a mortal.
How did she get here?
The North Wind brought her. She wants to see you. She has a present for you.
Send her in. Why have you come here, east of the sun, west of the moon?
I want to see Prince Jason.
No, you can't! Where did you get that?
From a friend.
Give it here.
Let me talk to Jason first.
I will take it away from you.
It will only play when given willingly. Let me talk to Jason.
Go out into the hallway while I decide what to do. I want that box.
May I make a suggestion?
What?
Trolls are tricky. Trick her out of the box.
How?
Let her speak to the prince, but give him a sleeping potion first.
Oh, what a bad, bad, bad idea. I'll do it. Go fetch some sleeping potion from Mother's cupboard of magic and send in Jason.
At once, Your Highness.
Jason, at least we have a few moments alone. Do sit down so we get better acquainted.
If you say so.
You're so fortunate to have a beautiful bride. Isn't my gown pretty?
I suppose so.
You admit that I'm the most beautiful princess in the world.
You ask a lot of questions.
Mother says I'm beautiful.
Really?
Why, how thoughtful of you, Mitty.
I'm not thirsty.
The prince wants to see you, princess.
Here, drink your juice. I'll be right back.
Don't drink that.
It's a sleeping potion. You're ready. Go growing out.
Why would Ermitson give me a sleeping potion?
To try and trick you.
I thought you were locked up in the dungeon.
Betty cut the webs with her scissors.
Why would Ermitson want me to go to sleep?
Jason, can you hear me?
Fayla, is that you?
Yes, are you all right?
I'm fine. Can you help me get out of here?
Yes. Pretend you have drank the potion. Lie down on the bench and pretend to be asleep.
Why?
Just trust me.
I think he's asleep already.
The glass is empty.
Hurry and get the girl. Tired, Jason? Just couldn't keep your eyes open any longer, my handsome prince.
Have you decided?
He's dozing. A little shake should wake him up. Now give me the box, willingly. Leave them.
Jason, I'm here.
Laura, it's you.
You weren't asleep?
No, I had to pretend. Irma too gave me a sleeping potion, and they called me Maggie to make me visit. So how did you get here?
The north wind carried me. We almost didn't make it.
I'm grateful that you came.
I don't know how to help you.
Jason, listen to me. Steph and Healthcare has lost all of her power. You must go and steal it now while she's sleeping. Then you can force her to let you all go.
I know where her bedchamber is. I'll go and steal it.
You ready? I'll come with you.
Jason, continue to pretend to be asleep. That will buy some time.
Let's have a nice chat.
I couldn't seem to wake him.
Oh, what a pity.
We made a deal. I gave you the box so I could talk to Jason.
You gave it willingly. Willingly. You cannot have it back. I'll consider it as a wedding.
How can you be so heartless and cruel?
Why, thanks for the compliment.
Should I throw her out?
No, she amuses me. Let her stay for the wedding. We'll send her limo after.
No, don't touch her. Let her go.
Jason, dear, you're awake.
I was never asleep. I know that you tried to poison me.
But the glass was empty.
Maddie dumped it out.
Oh, I've been tricked. How is this possible? Mother, help!
What is this mortal doing here? Who are you?
My name is Laura, and I'm here to rescue Prince Jason. I love him, and he is not going to marry your daughter.
Are you
little mouth, little rat? I will send you to limo immediately.
You have punished your majesty.
Oh, no, give me my staff, or I'll call my guard.
No, I'd call your guard, Helga.
Bela?
Look, this, it's been a long time, hasn't it?
How did you get here?
By your staff, you're powerless. Now let the people go, or you'll deal with me.
Let's go. special present
of us, and everybody signed it. And so
it shows you the audience. It's really